What happened?
Nobody knows.
What happened? What's happening?
I don't know.
An atrocity.
But it's not okay. What's happening? Daniela, what have you done to us?
Don't act like you don't know that.
What did they put in that whiskey?
This one is rock hard. So very dangerous.
This one don't work well. He's broken. This is a broke horse. You'll take it?
Break your finger.
Oh my gosh, it made it to you, didn't it?
Concussion?
By the way, that was a left-handed throw. I don't know if you know this, but I'm right-handed.
Yeah, this is violent.
I know.
It's for her pleasure.
Someone want this? Okay, I understand that.
Apparently Tammy does.
I'm gonna play that card, huh?
Yeah.
But here's the deal.
Thank you.
I have three kids.
Oh yeah, you sure have.
Although now I'm nervous.
Yeah, and also don't forget it has comes with music.
Yeah.
Yeah, yep. You don't want that anymore.
Yeah, who wants this?
You got one behind you too. It's one more.
All right.
Hi! My ex,
what are we doing?
My ex at one point read that if you want to sleep in, what you should do is get presents for your kids, toys for your kids, that they are only allowed to play with while you're still sleeping in the morning. And so Vicky bought the kids.
That's really genius.
It's kind of genius, right? She bought them a karaoke machine for that purpose. Not thinking it through. I was like, what the fuck were you thinking?
So Arrow has a little karaoke machine. And I call it the Make Dad Angry Machine. That's it.
Who wants to go first?
I'll go. I have a question.
Okay, what's your question?
Who cut your hair so short? And did you just say, give me the Dean Winchester?
Yeah. I showed the barber a photo of you in season 3. And I was like, I want to look like him.
And then the barber's like, listen, it's I can't work miracles.
As I was saying it, I realized what a terrible trap I had laid for myself. Like, no!
I'm a barber, not a magician. Thank you.
So I got to my hotel here in Rome, and I was like, ah, God, I look like a schlub. I hadn't had a haircut in a month. And so I went down to the front desk and I said, is there some place I can get a haircut around here? And they called a barbershop and they said they're free right now. And I went down, you know, the street and went into the barbershop and I said, we're just taking, like, neaten it up a little bit. And he took his scissors and the first snip was like down to my scalp. And so then he had to take the rest of it off. Otherwise it would have been a bald spot right there. And
Turned out that next door was the barber shop. He went to a mechanic's garage.
Yeah. So this is my Roman haircut.
Well, I actually think you look good, man. I think you look nice and dapper. And I'm not just saying that in front of you. I actually complimented him earlier about it. I said, I think it looks good, man.
It was a little weird.
It was weird.
And then he went in for a kiss. And I was like, whoa,
no. Hey, when in Rome.
Hi.
I have two questions. It's a two-part question. The first one is...
Thanks for prepping us.
No worries. The first one is, what's your favorite Italian food, and which food haven't you tried yet of Italian food that you would like to try? And the second one is, can I have the last unicorn?
What?
Favorite Italian food?
Yes.
I love all of the Italian food that I come across. But I have to say, I most look forward to the Roman artichokes and the cacio pepe.
That's my favorite one.
I just love those dishes.
Thank you.
You just love those bitches? What?
I love those bitches.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. I realize that this is not a unicorn. In fact, it's a llama.
Okay,
but you can have it anyway. And then to answer the first part of your question, bene alla arrabbiata. That's my favorite. I also just like the way it sounds, but I also like the translation, which is angry pasta. Yeah. I like it a spicy food. It's good. Although Daniil does make a... It's like a Italian sausage and like a green vegetable, maybe it's broccoli or broccoli rabe or peas into like a butter sauce pasta with the shells. Does this sound, or did she just make
that? That's just something that Daniil makes.
Well, she's part Sicilian, yeah. So she knows how to spice things up. But that is also hey. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, she does.
Hey.
Oh.
Now, she does refer to Misha as her boyfriend, so. Which is funny, considering
No.
Okay.
My caretaker, though, tells me I had a very nice birthday.
My night nurse.
I told you this, but I just discovered that I'm turning 50 next year. Isn't that insane? Not to steal your thunder. I know that.
No, it's fine.
35 is also a big year.
5-0.
Yeah. I mean, I'm currently
half
48.
A century, dude.
But next year.
Right, but yeah, you haven't quite turned 49.
Right.
Next year.
I'm going to turn 50.
Yeah. Yeah. I was told there'd be no math, but that's okay. Are you excited, or does that scare the crap out of you?
You know, I remember there's like, we've had canaries in the coal mine in our group, like Richard Spade and Rob Benedict. They always, it seems like they always reach an older age before we do. I don't know.
It's nice, isn't it?
But I remember when
Hey, buddy, I remember you're my canary.
I remember when Rob turned 40, and I was like, ooh,
that's gotta hurt.
Poor guy.
I know. Like it's just kind of straight down from there.
Gross. And then he turned 50, and it was just like, you might as well be playing a funeral dirge at that point.
It's like you can faintly hear taps being played all the time. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's like that.
I gotta be honest, I'm having some of the best years of my life right now.
I thought you were gonna say best sex of my life. I am having.
Well, that goes into that. I you know, you think like, oh, nothing could beat your 20s, and you get in your 30s, and you're like, oh, wow. I'm an adult now. I don't have the excuse of being in my 20s anymore, but still, I can have some fun. And the 40s is like, ooh, game on. Yeah. Now I've found my groove. And then 50, it all goes to shit.
Not true. Just
is that right?
She's like, no. this is exciting. Well, that'll be exciting.
Happy birthday.
All right, well, thank you. And man, maybe we should start planning something now for your big 50.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah. Don't you worry about that. I'm gonna look into that. And by that I mean I'll have Danielle work on it. She's the master planner. Let's take some questions, big guy. Over there.
Hi.
Hi.
So first, I wanted to thank you both for putting so much love and passion to both being a cast. So thank you so much for all the work you did. Sorry, I'm really nervous because you look so three-dimensional right now.
We've worked hard on that. Yeah.
But a very two-dimensional personality, so it's...
So I was wondering, if
you could rewrite the finale, what would you change, and what would you do? I think that I would probably have Sam and Dean die in episode 1518. You know? Right?
Castiel.
And then Castiel would be standing alone on a bridge. In the finale.
And you just say, finally, peace.
There'll be peace when you are gone.
I am done. there's a lot of different ways that I think this show could have wrapped up. I had ideas. I had dreams about how the show would end.
Do you all know Jensen's dream?
Yes.
How many know the dream? Oh, just a handful. You want to tell it? It's kind of great.
You want to hear me tell that dream?
Yes. I feel like crying. Do it.
I had a very, very vivid, for those that don't know, I had a very, very vivid dream, almost like a waking dream, years ago. And it essentially was, there was no words, it was just this music. And I don't know if you guys have ever seen that movie Man on Fire with Denzel Washington, but there, score to that, the soundtrack, there's this beautifully written score by an American composer, actually, and I'm blanking on his name. That was playing in my head while I was envisioning this vision that I had, and it was like the flyover of like just expansive farmlands as far as the eye can see. And there's just a long, long road going north and south, meeting a very, very long road going east and west. And Dean, sitting outside the Impala, parked in the intersection, nobody around, just desolate, every which way you look. And Dean sitting there, and he and I get up and I look way down the road, and I can see in the distance something moving towards me. And kind of like, did you see Lawrence of Arabia? Mm-hmm. When Omar Sharif is riding up the horse on the camel. It's kind of like that. And then as it gets closer, we realize it's a person on a motorcycle. And the person on a motorcycle comes all the way to the crossroads, to the intersection. And he gets off the bike. We never see a face because they've got a helmet on. And Dean kind of looks at the, nods at the motorcycle rider as he parks the bike and just sits there. And then Dean walks around the Impala, kind of like putting his hand on it like this, and makes a complete circle around the Impala, and then pulls the keys out of his pocket and hands it to the motorcycle rider. And the motorcycle rider, you never see his face, takes off the helmet and hands the helmet to Dean. And then cut to the Impala driving away. And Dean standing there holding a motorcycle helmet next to a motorcycle. And then he gets on the motorcycle and he drives in the opposite direction because he doesn't need a passenger seat anymore. And that was it. And so I always thought, I was like, and I've had that dream, and it was very vivid, and it rocked me. It was so vivid that I can still tell the story to this day as though it happened. And it was because Sam had died, and Dean was trying to move on with his life the best way he knew how, but he couldn't drive that car anymore because it just reminded him of his brother. And that was it. That was the vision that I had. I don't know, why are we talking about this again?
I will say we spent so much time with these characters and in the relationships between these characters that it became a blurry line, at least for me. I know this is true for you too, between the characters and our own emotional selves. And saying goodbye to Dean for Cass was also emotionally exhausting for me. And you,
this is all something that shouldn't be.
Danielle, I'll fix it.
Somebody bring him some whiskey.
Poor guy. yeah, I don't know. When you spend that much time with a character, it becomes part of you.
No, we're good.
It's so sad. I remember when you told that story when we were doing an interview. It was you, me, and Jared, and we were doing this long interview, and you told that story, and both Jared and I teared up when you told the story, because it becomes so real for all of us, And then you start dreaming those dreams. I had a similar experience just now working on Gotham Knights in the very beginning of the season.
Woo!
I had this... Woo! I had this dream that was so vivid. And I called the producers, which is a weird thing to do, but I was like, guys, this just feels like you start to spend enough time with the character and thinking about it enough, it affects your dreams. And I called them and I was like, I think I know how Harvey Dent has to become Two-Face the end of the season. And I told them what happened in my dream, and they were like, yes. And that's what they ended up writing. It was
wow.
Like, that became, wow. Yeah. But it was the same thing. Like when you told that dream, we hadn't yet shot the end of the show. And we were like, yes,
that's it.
That has to be it. So I would say, I would like to see that ending.
Yeah, me too.
I would like to actually just film that. Because there's no words exchange. I mean, it would probably be a 2-day shoot at tops.
We can afford it. You have an Impala.
This is true.
I have the Impala. I know how to get one of the cast members.
That's right.
Yeah.
I will say that there was a scene in the pilot of the Winchesters that was largely shot in the way that I saw that dream, And it was when we see Dean in the pilot of the Winchesters. There was that long road with nothing but just farmland on either side. That was kind of what I was envisioning for that dream, and that we did that a little bit as a tip to that. So yeah, that was cool.
Thank you.
But if I could change the pilot, I would probably just have hung a pillow on the piece of rebar.
An American show, and for us that makes it sometimes very hard to relate to it.
But shot in Canada.
That doesn't change anything. So to deal with that problem, there's for example this group of people on Tumblr who make the entire thing German and just make the characters German and set it in the German surrounding and stuff.
So, how do they achieve this? Is it like just storytelling? Just they just,
yeah.
Or do they overdub the
entire
thing?
It's like, just like text, just written.
Got it, okay.
So,
creative, that's cool.
Yeah, we do that a lot.
Yeah. Hello, Dan.
Actually, we changed the names.
Oh, the names are different? Wait, what did Dean get changed to?
Pizza.
What?
Hello, Dita.
Dita?
Hello, Dita.
Hello, Dita.
I'm Dita. Sprockets. what is Cass?
Carsten.
What is it?
Carsten.
Carsten.
We've been through this. We've had this conversation last year in Germany.
I know, but I remember nothing. Carsten. But my caretaker tells me it was a funny story.
What is Sam?
Samu.
Samu. Why did I get... Okay, never mind.
Dita.
my question is, in your imagination, what would a version of Supernatural look like that is more European?
I would think like Transylvania. You know?
Vampires?
Yeah.
I think there would be a lot more Gucci.
And they call it Googie. Because we can't afford the licensing rights. One of the C's is a K. So wait, what's the question?
What would we do to make it more?
What would it look like?
Right.
Yeah, I think it would probably be a little bit more like, you know, the Van Helsing.
Right, and maybe drive, it wouldn't be in the Impala, it would be a Fiat.
Yes. I mean, yeah, and you would have, you know, you would have Crowley on a Vespa just going, ciao!
Yeah. I don't know why this is...
By the way, this is the international sign for riding a Vespa.
Ciao.
Ciao. Ciao, boys.
Take it easy. I'm going to see him in 2 weeks. That's it. Thanks.
Oh, yeah. Hi.
Hi. So I've asked this question to Jared, but I would love to get your input too. So
you would like a correct answer.
Yeah, you'd like a right, correct, thoughtful answer.
Well, my question is, if the plot was to remain largely the same, but Dean and Sam had gone as solo hunters throughout the show, who would last the longest? Like, to season 15, pretty much.
Sam. And that's because he would be in a bunker doing research while Dean would actually be out doing the dirty work. What did he say?
Well,
he said Sam. But why?
I feel really on the spot now.
Yeah, no, it's fine. He said it, not you.
He said that Sam has been...
She's visibly nervous. I know. She's afraid you're going to be angry at her.
Yeah. He said Sam has been possessed more, so he can overcome more.
Oh, so Huey was like, oh, I can
he can find a justification for
it. I can withstand more.
The reason he's been possessed is because he's
the weak link. He's the weak link. Yeah, there's a reason Dean held out so long. Is because it took them longer to figure out a way in because he's such a tough motherfucker.
They possessed Sam because it's like the weak gazelle.
Right. It's because he's the gazelle. A giant gazelle, but a gazelle.
No photos.
And yes, as far as you're concerned, that's the whole answer. That's
correct.
Everything. Yeah.
That's as far as you're concerned.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey guys.
Hi.
The wheel looks really lonely, just saying.
The what?
The wheel behind you.
That thing is still here?
Hey Daniela, what are we gonna get rid of this thing?
What?
This thing. Pretty much right there, isn't it? This is, I mean, okay. Well, it's, hey, shit.
I'm sorry. I'm not.
Play us a song. Play us a song, Paul.
Why is this happening? Hey, Mish, you're welcome. You can take a break for a minute. Because here's the problem. I don't play them as often as Steve does, so he's kind of the guitar guy, and I kind of just do what I do. Something like, I knew this was gonna happen. Why can't I just sing something that's old? This is a hard song to play.
enough ticket shows, there's money to be made. Lawless gamble, that's the history of the trade. Did you weigh up all the cards left to play? Zero and sign up with evil and love.
And I don't know, that's good. One. Oh, hey, please. Let's write a song. Let's write a song.
Great.
I'll give you a melody. So it'd be like, hang on. So something like that. Did any of you guys record that? Because I literally just made that up on the spot, and there were some things in there that actually worked. We may have to finish that out. Right? Yeah, we won't. But it's something to think about.
Why not?
What's up, J-Rod?
Same old. What's up with you?
The ceiling?
Okay, what's up with you, Mishka?
The lights.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I feel like I answered mine.
You can't take my kindergarten response and give another one.
God? The angels.
What an idiot.
I don't know.
Do you hear about Superman?
No.
Yeah. 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 Natural call. Oh, you're not going to share it? Thank you.
Do you want to tell that, Jen? It's pretty good.
Yeah.
We were having a conversation about like
mortality
yeah. and kind of the meaning of life, and it was actually quite poignant. And then Jared
dropped some facts.
Interjected a little factoid there was a joke
proportional
that was deeply offensive right into the middle of it. But his delivery was so solid that we were all like, yes, yes. Oh! And then you got us twice with that. So I was impressed.
Almost thrice.
Yeah.
And I would love to tell
the joke. We can't tell the joke because we would be canceled. But it's a good one.
It's good.
We're already canceled. The memo just hasn't got to us yet.
I don't know. I haven't seen my email on a couple days. I've been bored of my phone like, but...
That's why we didn't give you
that's why. That's why we don't let you have nice things.
Tammy, your fucking goat is underneath your legs.
It's not a goat.
Singing.
It's a llama.
Llama? It's an alpaca, dumbass. Still got it. So, it was like 10 years ago. Oh, for shit. Was that 10 years ago?
Was it really?
Don't touch it again.
More. Press it again, it'll go off.
Stop it!
I did not
kill it!
Venetia, press it again.
There, it's
dead. Oh, don't press it, don't move it.
Wait, did you see that? She just looked, she pointed at it, and it died.
Yes. But don't move again. Because
witchy woman!
Well, we were gonna ask some questions, but between what's going on over here, we it's our time's up. So, alright, okay, Misha is pointing. Not anywhere near the person who wouldn't ask a question. He was pointing kind of like,
oh, okay.
Hi. Hi, welcome, Jared. we were already here.
Yeah, you missed when you walked out. No. I looked over at her and she goes like this.
You?
So that was a, hi, welcome, Jared.
Yeah. About time we were looking at our watches.
Yeah.
Hi.
Okay. So, at GPTEN, Jensen and Misha announced the Supernatural puppet show. But we, after years, we are still waiting. So we want a treason trailer right now.
A treason trailer?
Yeah.
A teaser trailer.
Oh, of the Supernatural puppet show.
Yeah.
Got it.
Got it. Got it.
That's what I heard. Yes.
Okay. Great.
Okay.
I think we need puppets. Do you have some for us? We can just do hand puppets.
You have the unicorns. You children.
Wait, I'm sorry. What are we doing?
We're doing the supernatural puppet show.
We're doing it.
And it's obviously for a European audience. So.
Okay.
Hello, dear. Hello, Samu. Hello, Pierre. The cat's on fire. Probably. Let's get in the Fiat and go.
Dear.
No, Dean, no, the Alfa Romeo. Dean. Dita. Dita. Dita, I love you.
Don't listen to him. Let's take the Alfa Romeo.
Dita, kiss me.
No, no kissing, no kissing. We suck at this. Yes, this. So we did this with Amazon. We tried to sell this, but it didn't work. So
we pitched it just like that to Warner Brothers. And they're still in development.
So we just, on behalf of...
And I got the deal.
Thank you, I think. Sorry. Thank you to you. Sorry to everybody else on the planet. Hi there.
There's some first-timers here, by the way. They're like, What in the...
Why did I come here?
Why? Why am I here? What am I watching?
I don't know why I'm here.
Thank you. Next question.
I've been standing here for 20 minutes now.
Yes, sir. What would you like to ask?
We are so sorry. Oh.
Okay.
Cry me a river. Cry me the Tiber River.
Okay, are you guys willing to tell on each other?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead. Like, what's a topic that the other hasn't been quite honest about that you can tell us? You want to tell us?
I heard something completely different.
Yes. He's coming back to where we are because he had a career. That's what I wanted to do. A lot of y'all don't know, but I've always said that Jensen will be honest with y'all about his thoughts on string theory. And,
yeah. My thoughts on string theory?
Yeah.
So what you want to do is you want to get yourself two soup cans. Then you take that string and you connect the two soup cans together. You can go as far away as you want. As long as that string will go,
that string
is going to carry.
Anyway,
it's going to carry that noise and
theoretically
be able to talk to you from here to there. It's an amazing theory of strings.
See, and he shared that with us, but never with y'all. Mishka?
You're asking us to share something that we have been, like,
not
privately shared with one another that we wouldn't want public.
I want the tea!
And I'm cool with
it. Like, yeah, that's great. I think we could. If ever there were a safe space, right?
I think it's here, yeah.
What happens in Rome?
It's actually just...
Actually follows you for the rest of your life.
Right? It certainly does. Yeah. I mean, I've been haunted by those bear underwear for some time.
We didn't need to go there, Misha. We could have gone elsewhere. But I went first, so carry on, fellas. The world wants to know. I mean, just this room in Rome, because it won't travel further.
So you want us to divulge some sacred information about one another?
Sure.
Obviously, yes.
Right. Is there a particular subject?
Yeah. Can you narrow it down? Yeah,
or,
so much dirt on each other, it's hard to start.
Like, give me a topic.
No. Cliff is saying sex, so...
Sex?
It's okay, it's his fault.
We've had it. Three times.
One, two. And on that note, I got a story for you.
Wrote a song on stage.
Let's hear it. Let's hear it.
And I want to ask you, the two of you, now that I have you cornered on stage, have you guys written music?
Live on stage?
Have you written
Written music live on stage?
Only when I forget the lyrics.
Yeah, when you forget the lyrics. Which happens lately.
But you don't workshop anything in front of an audience.
No. If you would ask me, I've written two songs this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't bring it up. They went straight to my tooth.
No, I don't have that experience. Please.
It was quite.
Can Misha sing it?
Can we
say we're Lucas?
No, we can't.
Can you hear it?
Misha.
You should sing it.
Misha.
No, he just gave me the serious. I'm not gonna do it. But like in a way that, like, I know my friend means it.
He's actually not.
We're not gonna do it. Sorry, guys.
Hey, can we really quickly, all jokes aside, can we take a moment before we say goodbye to give a big, fat, Italian, fucking amazing thank you to this weekend's volunteers? Respectable people and 12 questionable things. And so if it weren't for the gang over here, the gang that's still around, this weekend could not have gone down the way it went down. So thank y'all so much. And now quickly, Misha would like to do a song. Their mic's not working. Sorry, guys.
There goes Jared again with his job security.
Daniela, do you want to come up and say something to
everybody?
Yes.
She's coming.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Daniela. Thank you, Daniela.
Daniela.
To the mastermind that makes this all possible, we have all talked about, I think Jensen and Misha and I have done 150 or something travel opportunities to meet our extended Supernatural family. And we always talk about how Rome is our favorite, not just because it's an amazing city. You can see it in a day. Like, if you have a day, you can see the whole city of Rome. Not a big deal. But to be here
with
the crew that Daniela puts together is just fucking phenomenal all the time. So, Daniela, please.